You need to. Hey, man, you need to come to the realization that you're an Israelite and burn all those damn books, man.
That's madness, man.
And cut that lock off. Put grow you an afro in the beard and start calling yourself an Israelite, man.
Yeah, you are.
You got to change your name, man.
That's right.
It says, set you before the spirits. Set you before the spirits, the imperishable stars, the hidden ones worship you, the great ones surround you, the worshipers wait on you. Barley is threshed for you. Emer, if I'm saying that right, emer is reaped for you. Your monthly feasts are made with it. Your half-month feasts are made with it. As ordered, done for you by Geb. Remember Geb, your father. Rise up, O Teddy. You shall not die. Yeah, all right? That's just, I'm reading it, man. These guys are laughing at you, man. I'm not laughing. I'm dead serious, brother. Utterance 373 of the pyramid text. So do me a favor. Open up another tab and put utterance 373 of the pyramid text in there. Let's see what happens.
I got a quick precept. You know, and this is for you guys that's all into that Egyptology stuff. You know, I mean, we're laughing because it's comical. You know, but, you know, on a serious note, this is what the scriptures say. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1. So you're not going to read no crazy shit about no Geb sticking his, you know, rod up, you know, caressing you and addressing you and giving you his obelisk and all that stuff. This is Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1. Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with the covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin. And what you don't realize is by you doing that, you're basically worshiping other gods, you know, besides the Most High, because you are Israelites. At the end of the day, the bottom line, you know, the bottom line is that you guys are Israelites no matter what.
Yeah, there's other ways to be taken up in the heaven. You know, you can climb up to heaven. And another way is by ferry boat. And that goes in the Greek mythology. You got to have that when you die, they put the coins in your eyes so you can pay the ferryman, the boatman. Well, they got that from the Egyptians, right? It says another way is by ferry. If the boatmen refuse to take him, the king has other plans. If you fail to ferry Unas, he will leap and sit on the wing of Thos. Then he will ferry Honest to that side. You know, this sounds like some old fairy tale bullshit, man.
That's why the scriptures say this, if I may, real quick. This is the book of 1 Timothy 1:1. It says, neither give heed to fables and endless genealogies which minister questions rather than godly edifying, which is in faith, so do. Which, going back to that word faith. So the things that are in faith, that's what we're supposed to be doing. Not those fables, those fairy tales.
Yeah, we're not going to go to the museum and see a pharaoh from so many thousands, over 4,000 to 5,000 years ago, and all of a sudden we believe all that shit, man.
Right.
Okay? Right. Our thing is based upon faith.
Right, and then I'm going to look up that word fable real quick. I'm pretty sure we've looked it up before in the past. Right. Matter of fact, yeah, that's right. Mythos. That's where you get the word mythology from. Yep. Now that I saw the word, it rung a bell. It says a speech, word, saying, a narrative story, a true narrative, a fiction, a fable, an invention of falsehood. And that's basically what that is.
Here's another one. It says, apart from the burial of Unas, only the pyramid of Teddy displays a cannibal hymn. Hymn is a prayer. The hymn is a prayer. Now, they got on us about eating our babies,
right. All right?
As they call it. It says, Oh God, who lives on his father, on his father's, excuse me, who feeds on his mother's. Unus is the bull of heaven, who rages in his heart, who lives on the being of every god, who eats their entrails, you know, your guts, your organs. When they come, their bodies full of magic from the isles of flame. So that's another utterance from one of the texts, the text. So this is all bullshit. That's why if you got so many thousands of people and you try to teach them, they're gonna leave what you got, man. This is all confusing, man. This doesn't make going back to Occam's razor, man. You know?
A quick precept, real quick, since the apostle mentioned about faith. It says Hebrews 11:1. It says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Because it goes all the way back to faith. And when you read on, it tells you about I'm going to jump to verse 7. It says, by faith, Noah, being warned of the Most High of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house. Now, that's how you know that was true. Because why? It happened. And then the story of the flood is recorded throughout every culture. All right? And the Bible didn't plagiarize it. That was a world event that took place, man. You know, so all coaches, and they got the story of it. It wasn't no plagiarization. All right. It was something that actually happened. But now before it happened, they was talking to Noah like he was crazy. But Noah had faith in the Lord because the Most High told him it was going to happen. So it all goes back to having faith, man. You can't go into we ain't believing in this Bible because the so-called white man told us to believe in the Bible. No, we're believing in the Bible because it's the word of the Most High. And the Lord gave us that spirit, man, to understand the words, the prophecies that we see happening. Not because the white man said this is the word of God. Nah, we ain't going according to the white man's studies and stuff. All right, it says, not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. All right, so that's what it's all about faith.
Yeah, I got a precept. This is the book of 2 Peter 1:19. It says, we have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as unto a light, as that word light again, that shineth in a dark place. Like that pyramid text, that's a dark place, man. That's a dark, stinking, murky, cold, dreary dungeon place, man. A place that you do not want to be. Plus, you're susceptible to get your back end violated, all right? By Geb. Better watch out for Geb. If you see Geb, do not bend over, man. All right? Because you will see the light, a different kind of light. Yeah, we're making fun of it because it's garbage, man. You know, yeah, Teddy.
You know what? We can't help but laugh at the bullshit that you in, man. Like I said, let me see you get a big auditorium and teach a whole bunch of Jakes, and let's see if they come back to next week's class. Oh, they ain't going to come back, man. When you really get into this stuff and you analyze this bullshit, you find out exactly what it is. Bullshit, man.
Bullshit. Yeah. I'm going to read this again.
Unless you give them goodies, man, you know?
Yeah. I'm going to read this again. This is 2 Peter, the first chapter, 19th verse. We have also a more sure word of prophecy. This is sure. Whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as unto a light that shineth in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star arise in your hearts. Which, that's Yahweh Shai. You know, Yahweh Shai is... Geb is not coming back, all right? Yahweh Shai is coming back to destroy the so-called white man's world and set up his kingdom on the planet Earth. All right? That's the sure word of prophecy.
Hey, Geb ain't coming back. Teddy ain't coming back.
Teddy ain't coming back. Geb ain't coming back. Ra ain't coming back.
Ra was never here, man. That was a figment of somebody's warped brain, man.
Yeah, they're nothing but fables. You know, the scriptures warn us about cunningly devised fables. All right? Reading on, it says, 2 Peter 1 and 20, knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation, for the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of the heavenly Father.